In this video, we will see how we can work with the informations that come with a shapefile and how we can use these informations to filter our data set according to some specifications that we have. So off screen, I change a bit the symbology here that we can see these points better. And now I would like to use the information that are stored within the attribute table to select certain places here. This data set consists of restaurants, bars and cafes in Bern, and we're currently looking into a small subset of a small part of Bern. And now I would like to select those sites that are a bar, so that I know where to have a beer after the lecture. To do so, I can filter my data according to the specifications I have. First, let's have a look at the attribute table to have a basic idea what kind of data are stored here. One column that might be of interest for us is this amenity column, where here it says restaurant, but if we move down, we can see there are also a lot of bars and cafes stored here. So that's one of the columns that we would like to use to subset our data set. Another column might be, as we have used in the course here, this wheelchair column. So assume we have a friend with us that has a wheelchair and we want to include him in our having a beer action. So we would also like to filter the data according to the wheelchair options. From a more archaeological point of view, let's say you have a data set of sites and you would select all those sites that have a Bronze Age date with them, and also all those sites that are burial mounds, so that in the end you come up with the data set of Bronze Age burial mounds from your total collection of archaeological sites. Okay, how can we do that? To filter the data, there is a nice option here in the context menu, say filter, and if I click that, I have here a query builder tool that comes up. And one of the panes here, I have all the fields that are in the data set. Beside that, we have something that's called value, and down here we have something where a cursor is blinking, waiting for our input. I could just start and input stuff here, but we will use the query builder as a graphic user interface to make this filter query. Okay, the first thing we would like to have is to filter according to amenity, so that we select only bars. So I click here on amenity. And now I can use this value tab over here. It's still empty, but I can click on this all button, and then all data sets or all possible values of this data set are represented here. If I click there, you can see we have bar, cafe, and restaurant. If you have a very large data set, there is also this this sample button, and if you click that, this samples from the total data set. So if it's large, then this is much faster, but you might also miss some possible values here. Most of the time, at least in archaeology, you probably will go for this all option. So now we know that in amenity these options are present, and we would like to filter according to that. To do so, we have to build a query expression down here. And this is quite easy. We want to filter all the objects according to that amenity here, and I double click that, equals to bar, and I double click that again. And now you can see here the structure of such a filter expression. What is in double quotes is the field, and what is in single quotes is the value. And so I say I want to have every object where the amenity equals to bar. I can test this filter query first, see if it works. Yes, this works, and it returns 55 rows. Okay, and if I now press on OK, you can see that most of the points are gone here. We have only this point left here in the area that we are currently seeing. Okay, that was selecting for bars. Now we want also to select additionally to all the places that have wheelchair access. Again, we are first, you can see now here is this small icon that says you're not visiting, seeing the whole data set, you see a filtered data set. And if I hover over that, you can see that amenity equals bars, so that's the current filter that's in action here. Okay, I want to enlarge this filter. So again, I click right click on the layer and select filter. And now I want to have another filter expression, and that says wheelchair equals to yes. I'm looking for my column for wheelchair here. And first I have to connect that via an AND, because both of the specific values should be present. So I have to connect that with an AND. And then I double click on wheelchair. This wheelchair should be equal to, and I get all the values here, should be equal to yes. I double click that. And then we have this filter expression here saying amenity should equal to bar and wheelchair should equal to yes. Can test that query again. And now this clause gives us 5 rows back, which is not much. And I can click on OK. And now you can see that all of the points are gone here in our area. So nearby, there seem to be no bar with wheelchair options. If I want to see all the points again, I can click on this filter here, or again, right click on go to filter, or left click on this filter icon here. And then I can remove this or click here on delete. And then we see all the points again. Okay, with that, you can filter your data according to the different values that are stored with the data. And in the next video, we will see how we can use that to export a specific subset from our data that we probably would like to give to another person, for example, exporting only the Bronze Age burial mounds and send that to another person or use that later for different analyses.